And the senior executive director of finance at DLF joins us now to talk about that. Saurabh, morning. How is the situation on the ground currently? You were indicating that FY15 is a very tough year for you, but are you seeing any recovery at all in FY16? And what could the fresh bookings be for the year?
It's very difficult to predict because we are not a quarter-by-quarter business. So our projects are a little longer, and usually in the summer months, they go to the back city in the sales because people are not in town. They're usually on holiday. Sales usually picks up actually in the latter part of the fiscal year. So I would prefer to give emphasis or weightage to sales happening Diwali, first Diwali, and then to the fourth quarter. That's where the real pickup happens. So we're consistent in our business also, and ever since we've been in the state space, since 2007, we always find our third quarter and fourth quarter sales fully reflecting the sales effort that the company has taken forward. So on an annual basis, what we have articulated was that we do fresh bookings of about 3,500 to 4,000 crores during this fiscal year. This was in context to the current interest rates that exist in the country. This also the certain micro market conditions which are there, especially in New Gurgaon. And so keeping that into perspective, this is a number that we are at this stage guiding the markets to. If there's any change in this number, obviously we'll come and guide the markets accordingly.
Hi, Saurabh. Good morning, and thanks for joining me. Any fresh projects that you've lined up, or are these existing projects from where you will generate 3,000 to 4,000 crore rupees this year?
Now, these are existing projects, but the next phase of launches on those existing projects. We don't sell our projects on day one. We do it in phase wise. That helps us to match the cost elements that also exist in the marketplace. So these are the next phases of launches, whether they are in the luxury space and in the phase 5 of DLF or in other projects across the country. At this stage, 4 other launches are on the design stage, but we would prefer to bring those to the market after we do some private equity. In those particular projects, we would prefer to have a financial investor to come along with us because that helps us to keep the discipline and the timelines on development of those projects. That's our strategy as far as our residential sales goes.
Okay. And you have managed to get a very good response to luxury projects, both Camellias and Crest. Can you give us a sense of what is the unsold portion for these two projects that could result in revenue over FY16?
So again, I will not guide you on a quarterly basis. That's not our business. But the unsold percent residual value from these two projects itself is in excess of about 10,000 crores plus. And my cost to develop those, is about 3,500 crores. So we are talking here margins in excess of 7,000 crores in these two projects itself. That reflects the strength of some of our marquee destination projects that at some point of time will come to the market. These are two of them in DLF phase 5 as of now.
Okay, so what is the situation on the balance sheet front? This quarter your net debt has gone up to quite a bit. How much could you bring it down to by the end of this year?
So first of all, let me just make a statement that we are not uncomfortable with this net debt level. We are able to service this debt. We have the ability to get the requisite credit lines to take it forward. And we also need to distinguish between a development company debt and a rent company debt. Out of 20,000 crores of net debt, almost 14,000 crores is attributable to a rent company. This particular aspect of debt will continue to grow. As my rental incomes continue to grow, I will continue to securitize my rentals, and this number will grow as we go forward. And this is a very high quality debt which does not have any mismatches or refinancing risks. The net, if I were to deduct the 13,000 crores from the net 28,000 crores, what is left over about 7,000 crores. If my sales volume pick up, which we expect over the next two odd years for sure, then nearly my Crest and Camellias covers, the margins of my Camellias and Crest covers this debt project. That's the strength we really come and that's how we work our planning process. Having said that, yes, we would like to bring down the net debt number. But that will be more on the debt plus side of the debt, that's 7,500 crore of debt. That is something which will pay down. It will be dedicated on better sales volume that we achieve, whether in this year or next year, and also new launches that we will do. It is linked to that, but my rent for debt, as I said earlier, will continue to go up. My rent for debt may come down if we plan to go ahead and do the leaks, which we are to be contemplating in the fourth quarter of the fiscal year. That's what we think that we should be ready by. And if we are able to create the lead platforms, then obviously my rent for debt will also come off.
Okay, so your debt will be covered by the sales from Crest and Camellia, but what will your rent core debt be by the end of FY16 if REIT does not justify?
So that number would be about 15,000 crores.
Okay. Execution seems to be on track with nearly 13.5 million square feet delivered in FY16. How much are you targeting in terms of delivery this year, in terms of quantum of square feet and the number of apartments?
We haven't articulated a target for this particular fiscal year. There will be a number similar, actually more than this. As we speak, we have more than 10,000 apartments ready to be delivered during this current fiscal year. So, I don't have an exact million square feet number, but I can get back to you on that aspect of it. There will be a number which is similar to this particular year. Our focus has been very much on construction because we already have the locational attributes and to give the confidence to a consumer that I'm not here just merely making a promise based on an advertisement or a brochure. There is an actual execution happening on the ground for him to see. We haven't actually focused a lot on the construction side of it. And this is despite, I would say, muted sales volume. And that has, over a period of time, actually helped us to actually increase our sales in phase 5. And hopefully, this model will flow through in other micro markets also. So the focus will be on execution. We are at various stages, especially with respect to our legacy projects, to deliver them, complete them and deliver them during current and next fiscal year. The real profitability of the new projects will start to emanate in this current fiscal year. So just to highlight, my last fiscal year, I did not capture my POC and revenue and profit from Crest at all. So, and that's a pretty large bump up that exists. So, in this current fiscal year, those will all start to flow into my accounting books, which will reflect on our numbers going forward.
All right, we need to pay attention to the market as well. So, Mr. Kapoor, stay on, Mr. Chawla, I beg your pardon. In terms of the Nifty itself, there's been a big recovery that we've seen in the last 10-15 odd minutes, led by the Bank Nifty. So, the Bank Nifty is up about 0.5%. And just take a look at the intraday charts of names like SBI, PNB, moving to the high point of trade. It could just be an expiry-related adjustment as well. Remember, the market has been holding at this 8300, 8320 level for a while. Until expiry, we could hold Axis Bank, Bank of Baroda, and a couple of other stocks that are spiking up at this point in time. So good recovery still in the market in the last 10 minutes or so. But Saurabh, how many million square feet will you look to sell by the end of FY16, and what could the rental bookings be? That is, what could the leading volumes be for FY16?
So, rental bookings will be in the same range of about 1 million to 1.5 million square feet. That is the the leasing volumes that we expect during the current fiscal year. And on the sales volume side of it, we had already reflected that on a steady state basis, we will be doing about 7 to 7.5 million square feet of sales volume. However, pre-sales booking, sales bookings of about 3.5 to 4,000 crores.
All right, Sarah, we'll leave it at that. So that's some outlook by the company. Pre-sales bookings seen at 3.5 to 4,000 crores. We need to tip into a very short break. We'll come back and get chatting with the management.